Once again, great progress going here. I want to show you the fourth method for coloring, which is using actual photos for texture. So again, you need to be on your line art layer to select areas in order to fill them. I go to my magic wand and I'm going to click this big open space. That's pretty much the whole background behind this scene. Okay, and I like what's going on there, so I'm going to keep that. That's pretty much the entire background space. Every time you're done with the magic wand, select menu, modify, and expand your selections by 1 pixel. Then I'm going to jump down into Google. Let's close that. Let's go to File, New Window here in Google Chrome. And I'm going to click on Images. And I'm going to type in watercolor texture background. Now we get all these beautiful watercolory effects. Since this is a big space we need to fill for this drawing, I'm going to go to Tools, Size, Large. I want to try to find a decent size image of just some watercolor texture that I might like. And I kind of like this green right here, but what you want to look for is if it says 1, 2, 3, that's going to have watermarks, little watermarks all over it. So you don't want to find any of those. Let's just go back up to the top and free pick. They're always good. Let's see. Nope, we got a whole bunch of watermarks on there. But you know what? It's going to be a background texture. So I'm going to show you a little photo retouching trick to get rid of all these little watermarks. Save us a lot of time. Okay, those are over 1,000 pixels, so that's good. So what you want to do, let me close that and show you again. You click on the photo that you like. Then when you see this preview, you control click on a Mac. That would be right click on a PC, and you say open the image in a new tab. Right up here at the top, there's your new tab. If you hover over this and you click, you can zoom in even further to get the biggest version of this photo. Okay, we got a bunch of watermarks, but that's no big deal. I want to take this and drag it into Photoshop. So I'm just going to click and drag, and I'll pull my cursor right onto PS at the bottom of my screen. I let go of the mouse, and it jumps right into Photoshop. Now, this actually came up in Camera Raw. So I just click Open. And there we are. I'm in Photoshop. Here's my Photoshop file I've been coloring. Here's my file right here. Okay. What I want to do to this is, just to be safe, if you are on a PC and you're not available to do that, what you can do is right click and save the image. So if I do that, I can call that blue watercolor. I would save that image on my desktop. Then if that's the case, I'll close this up. I come into Photoshop and open the image right there from my desktop. Blue watercolor. Let's see if that opens. Okay, click open. Same thing. It opened up in Camera Raw, but there we go. I've got two different versions of it. So you can open up those files from your desktop, or if you're on a Mac, you just drag it right onto the PS icon. Now keep in mind, we have a vertical drawing, but I have a horizontal photo. So I can go to Image menu, since I'm looking at a horizontal image, go to Image Rotation, and I'll rotate it clockwise. There's my vertical shot. But again, I've got all these bad watermarks in here. So your fourth set of tools down are your photo retouching tools. If I press and hold, I have a spot healing brush. Okay, this is kind of tiny. So again, on a Mac, I hold Control key and Option key. And I'll drag to the right. If you're on a PC, you hold Control and Alt key and use your right mouse button. Drag to the right to make your brush bigger. And all I have to do is click and drag over those watermarks and they will disappear. Okay, I love the Spot Healing Brush. How easy is that to do photo retouching? So I just want to take out any of these little watermarks that are sitting all over this little background texture that I want to put into my file. So we'll take all those out. Just for learning purposes, you wouldn't do this in the quote unquote real world and sell it, because this is not right. This is not your artwork. This is somebody else's. So we're just using it for learning purposes. Okay, but you can take out all those little watermarks here with my Spot Healing Brush. There we go. I'll zoom out. Oops, missed one right there. So let's go over that. And we are free of watermarks. I love it. Now the goal is, how do I get this watercolor texture back over into this area? And here's the trick. When you have a selection made, you leave your selection turned on. You're gonna come over here, take your rectangle marquee, and you start outside the file. Click and drag over the entire photo. All you have to do now, because you have to have it selected first, is go to Edit, copy all of that watercolor texture, then you click on this tab. You come back to your drawing. You cannot just go to Edit and paste, because that's what's going to happen. Okay, so I'll go to Edit and obviously undo that. I have a selection made. I want to paste it into the selected area. So I go to Edit, Paste Special, and paste it into the selection. Okay, and you might be thinking, well, that was kind of really lame because I don't see anything happen. But obviously, I do have the photo there. It's just so small. So right here is your Move tool. Okay, the photo is too small, so I have to transform the photo. So once I'm on the Move tool, Command T on a Mac to transform, that would be Control T on a PC. And all I have to do is find the corner, hold my Option or Alt key to keep the photo centered, and I drag a corner and it will start to appear as I blow up the photo to fill it out. Make your photo bigger than the actual drawing so it completely fills that area. And there we go, we got watercolor texture. You always have to hit Enter or Return on a Mac to accept your transformation. And pretty much there's the four categories for colorizing line art. You can see it right here. I'll pull this down to the bottom. And let's just strip off all our layers. And these are the four coloring methods. Flat colors. Layer styles. We've added some dimension to it. Remember, you double click on the right to add a layer style. We've added filters for a little bit of that texture. And we've added actual, well, there's more filters right there. And we've added actual photos for texture. So my challenge for you would be to fill out the rest of this, or as fill out as much as you want. I mean, yeah, I've shown you four simple methods of coloring right here. If you turn this in, you would get full points. You showed me all four methods, but I think you could take this further, and I'm going to show you how to do shading on this in the next and final video for this coloring file. I'll see you in a minute.